welcome to Just For You. Before we start the show tonight, I'd like to give you a few trivia questions. First, what is Billy Idol's real last name, and what does he not like to eat? Second, who were Eggs Benedict named for? Third, who led the last stagecoach robbery in the United States, and name the year? And finally, what language has the most letters, and how many are there? Well, that's it for trivia, and I know that you're dying to hear it. But think about them, and I'll be back at the show to give you the answers.
Good evening. Tonight's album review is Cinderella, with their album Night Songs. Many of you have probably heard that about their gaining popularity, and this album here is a reason for their success. You might also have seen their video, Nobody's Fool, on MTV or something. Cinderella also got an award for Best New Group. Wow, the success at once? Could it be their long hair, flashy clothes, the cars they drive? Nah, it's this album here. Cinderella consists of, from left to right, Jeff LaBar on guitar, Eric Brittingham on bass, Tom Kiefer on vocals, and Fred Corey on drums. Side one is Night Songs, Shake Me, Nobody's Fool, Nothing for Nothing, Once Around the Ride. Side two is Hell on Wheels, Somebody Save Me, In From the Outside, Push Push, and Back Home Again. I'm telling you, every single song in this album is great except for one, and that one happens to be In From the Outside. It just wasn't my style. Cinderella also has special help from groups like Bon Jovi, Kiss, Ozzy and Sharon Osbourne, Jakey Lee, Randy Castillo from the Oz Band. While I give this band a lot of credit, on a scale of 1 to 10, I give it an 8. And don't forget to write in. Maybe you can win a dream date with me, the party boy, Dave O'Connell. Good night.
Hello, and welcome to another movie review. I'm really sorry if I sound kind of sore, but I'm sick, but the show must go on. Have you heard the latest news? The babe, Rob Lowe, took a part as a mentally retarded person in his new movie. I know, girls are speechless all around California. The movie Square Dance stars Rob Lowe and the girl who played Rena in Lucas, Winona Ryder. Winona plays Gemma, a 13-year-old teenage girl who's just plain and ordinary. Gemma never knew neither of her parents. She was brought up with her grandfather. And they have their ups and downs, but pretty much they get along really great. Gemma's life is really quiet until one day she has a surprise visit from her mom. Gemma decides to live with her mom in the city, where things are a lot very different from the country. People there are harder and meaner. That is, except for one person, a mentally retarded guy named Rory, played by Rob Lowe. Neither Gemma nor, except everyone makes fun of Rory except Gemma. Neither Gemma nor Rory belong in the city. And they two become buddies, and before you know it, they fall in love. Well, here's a clip.
Told my divorce that you and me be getting married sometime. I told you how to do everything.
No, I don't.
If you do, Jim.
Well, what'd your mama say to that?
She says fine by her. She say I need me someone good like that. I sure do like you, Jim.
Cut that out, Rory. That ain't no way for you to be talking. Okay, have a good day. I'll have the applesauce cake ready for you when you get back.
You know, I really got into Gemma's character, but it's funny because in this movie, every scene she looks different. I mean, in Texas, she looks like a lumberjack. And then in New York, she looks like a typical New Yorker. And then that scene just saw she looked like just a regular teenage in love. And also, I couldn't believe that Rob Lowe, after a bout last night, Oxford Blues and the popular St. Elmo's Fire actually took the part as a mentally retarded person. He says in a late interview that he took it so he wouldn't just be another pretty face. Well, give Rob Lowe credit, because he did an excellent job. On a scale of 1 to 10, I rate this movie an 8. And so grab your partner and go see Square Dance. Thank you.
Good evening. I'm Chris Kale, as you all know. And please, welcome to the letters segment of our show. Tonight, you're probably all wondering why I look so cool. That's because I'm wearing Dave O'Connell's sunglasses, or shades, as he calls them. Tonight, before I get into the show, I'd like to bring something very important to your attention out there, and that's it. Right now at JCPenney, all shower curtain rods are 25% off. Let's hear it. Thanks a lot. Appreciate your support out there. Thanks a lot. Okay, well, as you all know, I hope you all had a great Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday, because I didn't. That's because I only received one letter this week, and that means there's only two letters entered into the Dave O'Connell drawing. As we all know, that's the grandpa's drawing is for a night in the town with party boy Dave O'Connell. Okay, let me read you this letter here I received. It says, "Dear Chris, the only reason I'm writing you this letter is because I want that autographed picture of Dave O'Connell. But even more, I want that dream date with you, Mr. Kale. I have a problem, though. I have an IQ of only 9. I'm half Mexican and half Hebrew male. I guess you can understand my problem. I can feel for you, sir. I've been watching you on Just For You for a long time now, and you've really turned me on. Don't worry, I don't have AIDS yet." It goes on to say a few other things. I'm going to skip by here. "I really hope you pick me, Chris, because I know where you live, and I know what kind of car you drive, and in fact, I know everything about you. I will get you, Chris. Love, Pepe Kaplan. Pepe, I'm sorry. What can I say? Take a few laxatives. Call me in the morning. But please keep those letters coming in. The address is 3131 Stone Valley Road, Danville, California, 94526. Love you all, and please remember, peaches may be fuzzy. The salt on pretzels is still better."
You go out on a Friday night with some friends, maybe to a party or something. The common scenario could include drugs. Whatever you do drug-wise is your business, right? Well, when you report back to work Monday morning, your private life suddenly becomes everyone else's business and could ruin your livelihood. Why, you ask? Because your employer has made drug testing mandatory. If you refuse to take the test because you want to stand up for your constitutional rights, then you're out of there. If you take the test and test positive, tag, you're out of there. You're damned if you do, you're damned if you don't. The tests aren't fair. If you're in a room with someone smoking pot, you too would test positive for drugs, even if you are completely innocent. Besides, the tests don't prove whether or not you're a chronic drug user or an occasional drug user. Mandatory random drug tests violate the Constitution. They are the same thing as illegal searches. There should be some sort of suspicion of impaired behavior before a drug test is mandated. I think jobs involving public safety should require a pre-employment drug test. Jobs like pilots and air traffic controllers should require some sort of testing. But football players and high school students? Come on. I don't think drug testing is going to stop use of drugs among high school students. I think it will add to the problem because the dropout rate will soar. I'm not condoning the use of drugs in any position, but I don't think drug tests are the answer either. Thank you.
Good evening. I'm Spencer Hansen, and tonight I'm reviewing a TV show called Valerie. Now, Valerie is not an exceptional show, but it is one of the best shows on at its time slot. Valerie is a mother of 3 sons, and the show is about family morals. Here's a clip of Valerie and her son Dave, who change places with each other so that Dave can get a new car stereo. Why don't we take a look?
Number 6! Hey, number 6! We're not number 7!
We're not number 7!
We're not number 7!
Not number 7!
Dave, you are not going to believe this. We won the game 5-4. I scored, Willie scored, Judy scored, and get this, even little Lenny scored. And you know, Dave, this teamwork stuff, it's not nearly as terrible as you think.
Okay, let's celebrate, huh?
Yeah, let's have some pizza!
Pizza! Let's have some pizza!
David, no!
Well, I guess in all our excitement and our soccer merriment, we forgot that old Dave was in a hot kitchen cooking his little heart out.
Dave, we're sorry.
Yeah, well, sorry. He's not gonna save this roast now, is it, huh? which has had an extra hour in that oven because no one had had the courtesy to call and say that they might be a little late.
Oh, Dave, listen, we were so excited after the game, really, we just yeah. lost track of the time,
exactly,
right? And then we ran into friends at the pizza parlor, and it will never happen again. You know, Dave, listen, forget about the...
On what show did Rhoda, get her first start? Well, Rhoda should have been a big clue. It was the Mary Tyler Moore Show. Now, I realize that Valerie is no Cosby, Cheers, or it definitely isn't the Super Bowl, but it is the best show on at 8:30 on Sunday nights. So if I were you, I'd take a look at Valerie each Sunday night on NBC. On my rating from 1 to 9, I give Valerie a 7. Thank you.
Monte Vista, you ready to rock? Please welcome Huey Lewis and the News. That I'd rather be. Where else can you do a 500,000 things all at 1/4 to 3? Friendly bit of music, ooh, that modern music. You pack it with a lot of style, but it's still that same old backbeat rhythm. Really, really jars them wild. They say the heart of rock and roll is to beat. If the word I've seen, I believe them. Sunset Strip is something everyone should see. Neon lights and the pretty, pretty girls are dressed so scantily. When they play that music, that hard rock music, they dug it with a lot of flash, but it's still that same old backbeat rhythm. Really, really kicks you in there. They say the harder rock and roll is to be. If the word I've seen, Boston and old Baton Rouge, Tulsa, Austin, Oklahoma City, Seattle, Monte Vista too. And with the music, feel like music, bands with a million styles, but it's still that same old rock and roll music. Really, really just my, they say the harder rock and roll is to be. And for what I've seen, I believe them. Now the over may be barely breathing, but the heart of rock and roll, heart of rock and roll is still beating. Yeah. Heart of rock and roll.
Hi, it's Wen.
And welcome to People Are Babbling. Oh, by the way, did you get that new shampoo that we
Yes, I did, but they didn't have the ones that we had, but I did have the little samplers that are only 99 cents.
Well, did you know that it's National Orange Juice Week?
Yes, and we...
Oh, what?
We have a special guest today, and her name is Mrs. Treehide, and she's from the Orange Juice Company.
Yes. Well, as we understand that you have created this new product, welcome to our show.
Welcome to our show. Well, we understand that this product of yours helps maintain our beauty.
I guess you can drink much orange juice.
Yeah, it's obvious to me, you know.
No.
Well, will you explain it to us, or what's it called?
Oil of OJ, and it helps you look younger, too.
Oh.
Well, how nice. Well, as we understand that you brought us this picture of the tree, why don't you explain how it works
the tree.
And how you make this?
Oh, yes. The white pipe in there is to help get the orange juice serum up to the leaves to the oranges so that when you drink it, it can help you look younger, too.
Oh.
Ah, how nice.
Well, is this dangerous?
Of course it's not dangerous. I'm sure.
Yeah, it is.
No, it's not.
You're so
stupid.
No,
you're the one that's
stupid. Nuh-uh. Well, if we're not stupid, then who is?
Are you insinuating something?
You know.
Yeah, well, you know an orange juice face.
You call an orange juice face, dummy.
You don't call Wen dumb. Well, if she's dumb, then answer this question.
Yeah, if we stop taking your orange juice,
what
would happen to us?
Yeah.
Naturally, you get an autistic attack. Sure.
Like this man?
Yes, exactly.
Ooh,
oh, I see.
Ugly.
Are you having one right now?
Yeah. So it looks like
it. Well, as we also understand, you have a very special and important people use this product.
Yes, and I brought a picture with me to show you. I would have put a picture of me, but I didn't want to draw attention from the product.
Oh, well, we wouldn't want that, would we, Gwen? Oh, God.
Well, anyways, can we try your new Olive
OJ or whatever it's called?
Olive OJ, sure.
Olive OJ.
Why is it so thick?
I'm not quite sure.
Hurry. Well, cheers, Wen. I think we'll skip the OJ and use
stick
our
with oil of OLA.
Good evening.
Hey. And see you next week.
Drink your oil of OJ.
Bye.
Hello.
And.
Welcome.
To.
The news. Sorry, hello.
And.
Welcome.
To.
The.
News. Yesterday, little Jade Wilder got hit by a car while riding her tricycle. The car was going 45 miles per hour in reverse in a 25-mile-an-hour zone. One of Jane's neighbors, Dick Seaman, witnessed the accident and even got pictures. When asked about it, Dick described the incident as totally cool. The little brat was all over the street. Megan?
On the lighter side of the news tonight, an album was released today after the long-awaited comeback for the album and the Chipmunks, with their new release entitled Hanukkah with the Chipmunks. Some of the songs on the album include Hava Nagiva, Simon the Snowman, and Joseph the Big-Nosed Rabbi, and many other favorites. When we asked album why they released it so soon before Hanukkah, they replied, Bagel. Denise.
Moving on in the news, Zeke Ho is having some trouble down on the farm. One of his cows, Belda, knocked him unconscious with a swipe of the tail on Tuesday. Poor Zeke doesn't know what to do. He just can't get near her anymore. We used to have such fun together, he said with a little reminiscent smile. It's just that lately I've been paying more attention to my other livestock. Cows are nice, but sheep do it better, says Zeke. Well, Zeke, Megan and I wish you the best of luck and hope you can work things out.
In world news tonight, the cute, adorable little snuggle doll that advertises snuggle fabric softener was kidnapped by African terrorists late last night while the doll was sleeping in his New York laundromat. There has been no clue in the whereabouts of little snuggle, but FBI agents report that one Tyrone Secoseco Winslow Peterson Jr. of Zaire, pictured here in the middle, was last seen with the little furry creature. End result, the United States has declared war on Zaire and will send troops in until snuggle is returned with no harm back to the United States. Zarian officials have been reported saying, I quote, we ain't got nothing to do with that little fur ball. Well, update you on this late-breaking story when more information comes in. To you, Denise.
If you are worried about something in your life, says Dr. Jean Barlin, you should forget who you are and act like a tiger. This is the latest result from Barlin's research on sexual stress. Barlin's advice to all you stress viewers? Sit on the couch, close your eyes, and roar. Don't stop until you can literally feel the whiskers on your face and the fur on your body. I don't know about this guy. What do you think, Megan?
Not much.
Well, that's all for the news. That's the way it was. Good night.
Frosted Flakes.
Frosted Flakes. Well, here's the ingredient.
Sugar. Potassium nitrate.
Well, I think by that we can all see the fact that we'd rather eat okra.
Okra? What the hell is okra?
Well, Spencer, is that kind of food that when you eat it, it's going to make you want
to heave.
Well, please, if you have any other feelings about this, give us a call and write us at 3131 Stone Valley Road, Danville, California, 94526.
Hi, I'm back, so you won't have to wait much longer for the trivia answers. The first question was, what is Billy Idol's real last name, and what does he not like to eat? His real last name is Broad, and he doesn't like to eat meat. He's a vegetarian. Next, who were Eggs Benedict named for? The name originated when a lady named Mrs. LeGrand Benedict of New York discovered and told the chef of the idea. Going on, who led the last stagecoach robbery in the United States, and what was the year? The year was 1898, and it was a woman by the name of Pearl Hart. Finally, what language has the most letters in it, and how many letters are there? The language is Cambodian, and there are 72 letters. Speaking of letters, if you want to write us any, you can write to Monte Vista High School, care of Rainbow Studios, 3131 Stone Valley Road, Danville, California, 94526. We hope you enjoyed the show. Thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you next week on Just For You. There's life in-